Hi, Julian here. The tie-in points on jacket pipes can be of special interest. The calculation according to pipeline codes is not possible because no I or K factors are available. A calculation must be made using the finite element method. ROHR2fesu is able to model and calculate jacket pipes. In this video I would like to show you how to calculate such a tie-in point with ROHR2fesu. As usual, the basis is a pipe structure in ROHR2. In this case, the transition from normal pipeline to jacket pipeline is modeled by a spherical disk and a torus-shaped junction. Therefore, I can prepare this by adding a head on the outer pipe. The relevant areas are delimited by intermediate nodes, selected and transferred to ROHR2fesu. Pay attention when assigning the segments to the substructure that you do not forget to choose the inner and outer pipe. After defining basic meshing parameters, the intersection of the nozzle has to be modeled. The intersection is designed as a nozzle with an internal projection. There are two types of internal projection. In the first variant, the projection is specified in millimeters from the intersection line and the cross section at the end of the projection is parallel to the intersection line. In the second variant, selected here, the projection is modeled as far as the endpoint of the superelement reaches. Only in this variant, a connection to ROHR2 or another superelement can be made. The crucial point is to assign the correct pressure in order to establish the equilibrium in the system. In this case, the simple pipeline should have a pressure of 10 bar. Inside the outer shell of the jacket pipe should be a pressure of 0.2 bar. This means that the pressure inside the inner pipe of the jacket pipe is reduced from 10 bar to 9.8 bar. By default, a substructure is assigned one pressure and one temperature. Since this is a special case, the option that operating data can be assigned separately per superelement must first be activated. The inner projection cannot be assigned its own operating data separately, since it belongs to the nozzle. By adding a new superelement at the end of the inner projection, this circumstance can be eliminated, since this can be assigned operating data separately. If a superelement is connected to an inner projection, the elements at the projection are not pressurized with a pressure of 0 bar, but the operating data are taken over from the subsequent superelement. Now the operating data can be assigned to the individual superelements from the ROHR2 interface. The assignment can be controlled graphically with the help of the segment properties. If a coupling is already defined in ROHR2 at the tie-in point, many steps are automated: the creation of the intersection, the internal projection, and the insertion of an additional superelement. Only the operating data must be assigned.